talking. Like, nigga, I'm coming. When I come, bro, we gonna fight. Like, I ain't coming on no shit. Like, oh, I'm just doing this shit for this clout and this and that. You get what I'm saying?
What I'm saying is, you ain't that.
Okay.
You're not that yet. You should have waited.
But I see your coaches.
You should have waited for a little bit more time. You stuck your head out there a little too soon.
Nah, you completely shut off.
You think I did it too soon. You know how niggas come like, and they come suited up, and that top dog get clipped.
What's going on with all my billionaires out there? This the guy, Hoods Billionaire. Welcome to Hoods Billionaire TV. Big favor, big abundance on today's episode. We got fight predictions for the Javante Tank Davis and Frank Martin fight, man. Let's talk about it. So, we got a big fight coming up June 15th. Going to be at the MGM Grand in Las Vegas. Javante Tank Davis going to defend his lightweight belt at 135. Against Frank Martin. Okay, Javante 29-0, 27 knockouts. Frank Martin 18-0, 12 knockouts. Javante's knockout ratio is, that percentage is higher than Frank's. But Frank, that's a lot of knockouts for the number of fights, right? And then he just took out Rivera not too long ago. The guy that looked like Muhammad Ali. Right, and took him down. So I like Frank Martin's style. They both southpaw, right? This is gonna come down to styles make fights, right? We gonna start with Tank, right? Because Tank the one defending the belt, okay? Tanks, a lot of people. And I've said this on too many videos. You can just go back and look at all of them where I've clearly said this. Like, Tank's boxing ability does not get enough credit. He reminds me of Mike Tyson from the sense that Mike Tyson's boxing ability never really got the credit it deserved. It really didn't. Mike Tyson's footwork, head movement, his ability to slip punches, counter punching, big power punches out of defensive stance, footwork, ring awareness, everything. Like, Mike was drastically underrated. It's the same with Javante. Javante is so, his boxing ability is so underrated because of his knockout power, right? And he has power in both hands. Pretty much everybody that sparred with him then said the same thing, that this man got knockout power in both hands and he not nothing to be played with. Right, and we see that, right? But what else do? And this is for people that really love the sweet science, right? If you really know what you're looking at, you can see a guy with good ring awareness, gets good angles, a good counter puncher. His endurance is high. He had the same power in round one that he have in round 12. We've seen that multiple times. Okay, he doesn't just have that counter uppercut. He pretty much has every punch in his arsenal. Good jab, footwork, spacing, defense. You know what I'm saying? Tank is definitely pretty solid with defense. Got a pretty decent chin also as well. Good timing. Tank does not. And Tank can box. Like, he can box. Like, Tank does not get enough credit for his ability of what he can do in total. Real talk. And of course he does have knockout power. But do you know why his knockout power translate the way that he does to have fucking 27 KOs out of 29 fights? Because he can box so well. Because his counter punching is so efficient. Right? His counter punching is so efficient. He boxes well. He sets up his shot so well that power always translates to a knockout. You see what I'm saying? So, man, it just is what it is, man. I mean, that's really what's going on. You know what I'm saying? Tank is a beast. He an animal. But respect his overall boxing ability. Now, we're going to break down Frank Martin. He started a little bit later in his boxing career. I believe around like 18, somewhere around there. But Frank Martin is solid, man. Real solid. You know what I mean? Good jab. A good jab, good footwork, real stiff jab, good combinations, good just the way he stays center. He won't move off his point, you know what I mean, where he really want to sit down on his punches and pick his shots. Really crisp, you know what I mean, he throws really crisp punches. Good work rate, good defense, good angles, definitely shifts around a lot. Like, I like, if you go low on him to touch the body, he is going to put his forearm on you or grab your hips, and he gonna twirl around you, right? He gonna get a different angle. So he really good with that, really really good with those angles. And just keeping good distance with a good stiff jab, and he got some knockout power too. Good counter puncher, you know what I mean? I watched some Frank Martin because me and him got like a similar body type, you know what I mean? Like muscular guys, we got a really more so, you know, like work on throwing a lot of punches to kind of break down that muscle fiber so we can just throw like a good solid crisp. You got to be able to translate that power. Like, just because you have muscles don't mean that translates into power. That's where a lot of people go wrong. It doesn't translate into boxing or fighting at all. It has no translation. But, you know, if you know how to translate that that muscle power into punching power, right, with good, clean, crisp punches, right, and good, clean angles, right, and another thing, Frank Martin got good conditioning also as well, then you know you working with something, right? So I like Frank Martin. I like his style. I like how he move, right? I like how he go. This is gonna be a tough test for Tank. I don't think this is gonna be easy. I think it can go either way. Like a lot of people got Frank. See, I watch enough boxing. It could go a plethora of ways. It could go 12. It could go decision. It could definitely go 12 and be decision. You know, I don't see Frank getting KO'd. It can go 12 and be decision, but that can happen too also as well. And if Tank do knock him out, I say it's probably later round, somewhere between anywhere from maybe like 9 to 12, 8 to 12. If it does happen, Frank Martin, I could see him going the distance, it going to decision. If he played the points game and picked up them early rounds, that can happen for him. I couldn't see him knocking Tank out. I don't know if I could see that. Could it happen? I mean, it's possible. I don't know if I could really see that one. Just because, like I said, Tank's boxing ability and the way he move around the ring, he not finna just get caught flush multiple times like that. But do I believe that Frank could beat him on points if he played? If he get them early rounds, yeah, I do. Yeah, I do. And if Gervonta never really get a clean shot or knockout on him, I believe he can handle it. So we gonna see, but. If I had to put my money on somebody, I'd probably go Tank. Would I bet on the KO? I don't know. I'm 50-50 on that. It could go KO. It could go decision. You know what I mean? Seeing how, you know, Pitbull Cruz style. And Pitbull Cruz and Frank Martin style a little bit different. But just both strong boxers. You know what I mean? And that's what I mean. Ryan Garcia isn't that strong of a boxer. He really just got a left hook, and he can throw it from any angle, and he can throw it at any time, and he got power at any time. But as far as like just the best boxer, no, right? Pitbull Cruz, guys like Frank Martin, they're good boxers. So I don't know if Tank gonna knock out Frank because he's a good boxer. So, we'll see. Styles make fights, man. Y'all let me know what y'all think in the comments, man. Y'all tell me who y'all think gonna win, man. It's the guy who's being there. Big favor, big abundance. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Like, share, subscribe. Turn your notifications. It's the guy who's being there. Big favor, big abundance. I'm gone. And I'm probably gonna do something on that Go Yayo and Sauce, too. Because they got a boxing match coming up from what I heard. That's being reported on the streets. I'm probably gonna make a video on that, too, man. It's the spirit of hands out in this motherfucker. Your boy training for Golden Gloves right now, man. So I'm gonna definitely have some footage for that for y'all. So y'all let me know what y'all think in the comments, man. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe. All right, I'm gone.